Good evening. In tonight's scripture readings, St. Paul counsels us to conduct ourselves in a way worthy of the gospel of Christ. And in the gospel, we are reminded through a parable that Jesus shares that the last will be first and the first will be last. Let us pray this week that we can truly walk in a way that is worthy of the gospel of Christ. Please stand and worship the Lord in song.
Let us sing together, sing a new song. Sing a new song unto the Lord. Let your song be sung from mountains high. Sing a new song unto the Lord, singing Alleluia. Shout with gladness, dance for joy. Oh, come before the Lord and play for God on glad tambourines, and let your trumpets sound. Sing a new song unto the Lord, let your song be sung from mountains high. Sing a new song unto the Lord, singing Alleluia.
Good evening. Let's continue our celebration in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord is with you.
And with your spirit.
We come together this evening and sing a new song to the Lord. And the best song that any of us can sing is the gift of our lives, the choices that we have made. And sometimes our choices have not always been ideal. We've wandered away from God. So before we continue, let's be touched by God's mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. And so then, may Almighty God have mercy on us and forgive us our sins, bring us all to life everlasting. Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will.
Let us pray. O God, you founded all the commands of your sacred law upon love of you and our neighbor. Grant that by keeping your precepts, we might draw closer to you and each other. We pray this through Christ the Lord. Amen.
The first reading is a reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call him while he is near. Let the scoundrel forsake his way and the wicked his thoughts. Let him turn to the Lord for mercy, to our God, who is generous in forgiving. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord. As high as the heavens are above the earth, so high are my ways above your ways, and my thoughts above your thoughts. The word of the Lord.
Is near to all who call on him. The Lord, he is near to all who call on him. Great is the Lord and highly to be praised. God's greatness is unsearchable. The Lord, he is near to all who call on him. The Lord is good to all and compassionate toward all his works. The Lord, he is near to all who call on him. The Lord is just in all his ways, and holy in all his deeds. The Lord, he is near to all who call on him. The Lord, he is near to all who call on him.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, Christ will be magnified in my body, whether by life or by death. For to me, life is Christ, and death is gain. If I go on living in the flesh, that means fruitful labor for me, and I do not know which I shall choose. I'm caught between the two. I long to depart this life and be with Christ, for that is far better. Yet that I remain in the flesh is more necessary for your benefit. Only conduct yourselves in a way worthy of the gospel of Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Open our hearts, O Lord, to the words of your Son.
Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia.
May the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
This is a reading from His Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you.
Jesus told His disciples this parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a landowner who went out at dawn to hire laborers for his vineyard. After agreeing with them for the usual daily wage, he sent them out into the vineyard. Going out about 9 o'clock, the landowner saw others standing idle in the marketplace, and he said to them, "You too go into my vineyard, and I will give you what is just." So they went off. And he went out again around noon and around 3 o'clock and did likewise. Going out at 5 o'clock, the landowner found others standing around and said to them, "Why do you stand here idly all day?" They answered, "Because no one's hired us." He said to them, "You too go into my vineyard." When it was evening, the owner of the vineyard said to his foreman, "Summon the laborers and give them their pay, beginning with the last and ending with the first." When those who had started about 5 o'clock came, each received the usual daily wage. So when the first came, they thought that they would receive more. But each of them also got the usual wage. And on receiving it, they grumbled against the landowner, saying, "The last ones worked only 1 hour, and you have made them equal to us, who bore the day's burden and the heat." He said to one of them in reply, "My friend, I'm not cheating you. Did you not agree with me for the usual daily wage? Take what is yours and go. What if I wish to give this last one the same as you? Or am I not free to do as I wish with my own money? Are you envious because I am generous?" Thus the last will be first, and the first will be last. The Gospel of the Lord.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Today's gospel, we hear about the awesome generosity of God. We hear about how God always wants to connect with us. Our new DRE, Uta Eble, is now going to share some reflections with you about how that might be possible here at IHM.
Hello. For those of you who haven't met me yet in person, like Father Bob said, my name is Uta Eble. The name and the accent is German, so I grew up there and I was born there, and then I met my husband there when he was stationed as an Army, U.S. Army helicopter pilot in Germany, and we got married in 2005, and then I moved with him to Alabama, then Hawaii, then back to Germany, then back to Alabama, then back to Hawaii, and now he is back in his hometown, not in the Army anymore, still flying helicopters. And if you see me, I'm still getting adjusted to not Hawaii, so I may or may not have turned on the heat in the car today.
I did.
And so we have 4 children. They are all at IHM in kindergarten, 4th, 6th, and 8th grade. And we are so happy to be here. Today is actually Catechetical Sunday, and that's what I wanted to talk about. Catechetical Sunday is when the church emphasizes catechesis, religious education, but it's not just classes that you take, religious education classes. Catechesis is the totality of the efforts of the whole church to make disciples. And we are all called to make disciples because in Matthew 28:19, Jesus told his disciples at the time to go and make disciples out of all the nations and to baptize them in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. So even before we got baptized, we were called to be disciples. And discipleship is, of course, knowing, loving, and serving God. And because we are all in one church, it's the responsibility of all of us to do catechesis, to form each other and ourselves in faith. That can be either by being a good example in the community, by being a welcoming community for all those who are joining the Catholic Church, either as adults or as children, and explaining what the reason is for our joy as Christians. So, of course, the parents are the ones that have a special responsibility of making their own disciples at home, that is, their children. But as a community, as a church, we want to help them, because it's, if you have children, you know it's not easy, and it takes a village or a church to raise them. One way we are doing this is through Sunday Family Faith. So for all the children that are not in a Catholic school and getting religious education there, we want to make sure that they receive some kind of religious education outside of the home. And for us, that would be on Sundays in Sunday Family Faith. Tomorrow is actually the first day that we have classes, but it's not too late to sign up. You can do that on the website. I also want to emphasize that this year we have classes for 7th and 8th graders. So I know there wasn't a Sunday Family Faith class last year, but I urge you, if you have a 7th and 8th grader at home, enroll them there. We have two young, energetic, highly relatable teachers for them, and it's just good to get them in the habit of lifelong learning and to get away from the graduation mentality that at some point we graduate from religious education. Because we all are called to grow in our own faith and to get to know God better. Also, we have RCIA, that's the Rite of Christian Initiation. So if you're an adult and you're coming to Mass, but you're not Catholic yet, why don't you come join us on Monday nights at 7 and learn more on an adult level what our faith is about and what your family that you're going with is believing. And then maybe we can convince you that this is something that you need in your own life too. For Sunday Family Faith and any other program, we're always looking for teachers. And again, since we have this responsibility to make disciples, I call on you to think about and pray about volunteering as a teacher, and so to fulfill your mission to make disciples. What I want you to take away from the gospel today is not just the incredible generosity of our God, it's also that there's never enough workers in the vineyard. All are welcome. God will take you in any shape you are in. And remember, He doesn't call the equipped, He equips the call. So you can approach me if you're interested. No worries, we're not just going to throw you into the water. There will be training, there will be mentorship, you will not be alone. You cannot mess those kids up. We will be with you. And I also want you to ask yourself, have I been learning and growing in my own faith? And if the answer is no or not enough, come see me and together we can remedy that. Thank you.
Thank you, Yuta. We're glad to have you here. Let's stand now and profess the faith that joins us. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray.
For the church, that we may strive always to conduct ourselves in a way worthy of the gospel of Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For political leaders at every level, that they may be compassionate to those who are most vulnerable, to those who have been overlooked or forgotten. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who work in fields, on farms, and in vineyards, harvesting the food we eat, that they may be rewarded generously for their labor. We pray to the Lord. For our Jewish friends and neighbors, whose celebration of Rosh Hashanah, the New Year, ends Sunday, we pray to the Lord. That our parish community may invite and welcome others at all times with generosity modeled by the landowner in today's gospel, we pray to the Lord. For the intention of this Mass, Lowell Bucher. And for the needs that rest in the silence of your heart. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Gracious God, we do know you hear our prayer. So we gather here this evening and share with you our hopes and dreams and needs. We pray you grant these things that they be for our good, as this day is always, through Christ the Lord. Amen.
Let us sing together, Open My Eyes.
Open my eyes, Lord. Help me to see your face. Open my eyes, Lord. Help me to see. Open my ears, Lord. Help me to hear your voice. Open my ears, Lord. Help me to hear. Open my heart, Lord. Help me to love like you. Open my heart, Lord. Help me to love.
Let's pray now, my sisters and brothers, that these gifts will be pleasing to our loving God. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Receive with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be theirs through this Eucharist. We pray this through Christ the Lord. Amen. Amen. May the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, gracious God. Through your beloved Son, Jesus the Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, the Savior you sent to bring us hope, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, Jesus stretched out his hands as he endured his passion so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. We join then with angels and saints in proclaiming your glory as we sing.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory.
the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, save us, Savior of the world. For by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you and one another. Humbly, we pray, that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. And remember, Lord, your church that is spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity with Francis, our Pope, and Charles, our Bishop, all bishops, all clergy, all who minister. And remember as well our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. And have mercy on all of us, we pray, that with Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, and Joseph, her spouse, and the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus, who is the Christ. For through him, with him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory, all honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Now pray with trust and confidence to our common God, and use the words of Jesus.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Free us, Lord, from all that is evil. Grant us peace in our time. In your mercy, keep us free from sin. Protect us from worry as we wait in joyful hope for the coming again of our Savior, Jesus, who is the Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Lord Jesus, you said to your disciples, you say to us, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our faults, but on our faith, and grant us the peace and unity of the kingdom where you live forever and ever. Amen. Amen. May the peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
And let's share with each other now a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Let us sing together, You Are Near. I sit and when I stand, your hand is upon me, protecting me from death, keeping me from harm. Oh Lord, I know you are near, standing always at my side. guard me from the foe, and you lead me in ways everlasting. Where can I run from your love? If I climb to the heavens, you are there. If I fly to the sunrise or sail beyond the sea, still I'd find you there. You know my heart and its ways, you who formed me before I was born. In the secret of darkness, before I saw the sun, in my mother's womb. Oh Lord, I know you are near, standing always at my guard me from the foe, and you lead me in ways everlasting.
Stand now and conclude our prayer. Graciously raise up, O Lord, those you renew with this sacrament, that we might come to possess your redemption both in mystery and in the manner of our life. We pray this through Christ the Lord. Amen. Amen. May the Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Mass is ended. Go in peace and love and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.
And let us sing together, 'Tis the Gift to be Simple. 'Tis the gift to be gentle, 'tis the gift to be fair, 'tis the gift to wake and breathe the morning air, and every day to walk in the path we choose. 'Tis the gift that we pray we may ne'er come to lose. When true simplicity is gained, to bow and to bend, we shan't be ashamed. To turn, turn will be our delight, till by turning, turning we come round right. 'Tis the gift to be loving, 'tis the gift best of all. Like a quiet rain, it blesses where it falls. And if we have the gift, we will truly believe, 'tis better to give than it is to receive. When true simplicity is gained, to bow and to bend, we shan't be ashamed. To turn, turn will be our delight, till by turning, turning we come round right.